Thursday, 4th August 2021. Let my prayers be set forth in your sight as incense, and let the lifting up of my hands be an evening sacrifice. Let us humbly confess our sins to Almighty God. Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from your ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against your holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done, and we have done those things which we ought not to have done, and apart from your grace, there is no health in us. O Lord, have mercy upon us. Spare all those who confess your faults. Restore all those who are penitent, according to your promises declared to all people in Christ Jesus our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we may now live a godly, righteous, and sober life, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Grant to your faithful people, merciful Lord, pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins and serve you with a quiet mind, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouths shall proclaim your praise. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be. World without end. Amen. Praise the Lord. The Lord's name be praised. O gladsome light, pure brightness of the ever-living Father in heaven. O Jesus Christ, holy and blessed, now as we come to the setting of the sun, in our eyes behold the vesper light, we sing your praises, O God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. You are worthy at all times to be praised by happy voices, O Son of God, O giver of life, and to be glorified through all the worlds. My God, why have you forsaken me, and are so far from my cry, and from the words of my complaint? O my God, I cry in the daytime, but you do not hear, in the night season also, but I find no rest. But you remain holy, enthroned upon the praises of Israel. Our fathers hoped in you, they trusted in you, and you delivered them. They called upon you and were delivered. They put their trust in you and were not confounded. But as for me, I am a worm and no man, scorned by all and the outcast of the people. All those who see me laugh me to scorn. They curl their lips and shake their heads, saying, "He trusted in God that he would deliver him. Let him deliver him if he will have him." But you are he that took me out of my mother's womb. You were my hope when I was yet upon my mother's breasts. I have been cast upon you ever since I was born. You are my God, even from my mother's womb. Go not far from me, for trouble is near at hand, and there is none to help me. Many oxen have come around me, fat bulls of Bashan close me in on every side. They gape at me with their mouths like a raven, like a ravening and roaring lion. I am poured out like water, and all my bones are out of joint. My heart also is in the midst of my body. My heart also in the midst of my body is like melting wax. My strength is dried up like a potsherd, and my tongue cleaves to my gums, and you bring me into the dust of death. For many dogs have come about me, and the counsel of the wicked lay siege against me. They pierced my hands and my feet. I can count all my bones. They stand staring and looking upon me. They part my garments among them and cast lots for my clothing. But be not far from me, O Lord. You are my succor. Hasten to help me. Deliver my soul from the sword, my life from the power of the dog. Save me from the lion's mouth, and my soul in misery from among the horns of wild oxen. I will declare your name to my brethren. In the midst of the congregation I will praise you. O praise the Lord, you that fear him. Magnify him, all you seed of Jacob, and fear him, all you seed of Israel. For he has not despised nor abhorred the low estate of the poor. He has not hidden his face from him, but when he called unto him, he heard him. My praise is of you in the great congregation. My vows will I perform in the sight of those who fear him. The poor shall eat and be satisfied. Those who seek after the Lord shall praise him. May your hearts live forever. All the ends of the world shall remember and be turned unto the Lord, and all the families of the nations shall worship before him. For the kingdom is the Lord's, and he is the governor among the peoples. All those who sleep in the earth, how shall they worship him? All those who go down into the dust, how shall they kneel before him? But my life shall be preserved in his sight, and my children shall worship him. They shall tell of the Lord to the generations to come, and to a people yet unborn shall they declare his righteousness, that he has brought it to pass. The Lord is my shepherd, therefore I lack nothing. He shall feed me in green pastures and lead me forth beside the waters of comfort. He shall refresh my soul and bring me forth in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me, your rod and your staff comfort me. You shall prepare a table before me in the presence of those who trouble me. You have anointed my head with oil, and my cup shall be full. Surely your goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from the first book of Samuel, beginning with the 24th chapter, the first verse. When Saul returned from following the Philistines, he was told, "Behold, David is in the wilderness of En-Gedi." Then Saul took 3,000 chosen men out of all Israel and went to seek David and his men in front of the wild goats' rocks. And he came to the sheepfolds by the way, where there was a cave, and Saul went in to relieve himself. Now David and his men were sitting in the innermost parts of the cave, and the men of David said to him, "Here is the day of which the Lord said to you, 'Behold, I will give your enemy into your hand, and you shall do to him as it shall seem good to you.'" Then David arose and stealthily cut off a corner of Saul's robe. And afterward, David's heart struck him because he had cut off a corner of Saul's robe. He said to his men, "The Lord forbid that I should do this thing to my Lord, the Lord's anointed, to put out my hand against him, seeing he is the Lord's anointed." So David persuaded his men with these words and did not permit them to attack Saul. And Saul rose up and left the cave and went on his way. Afterward, David also arose and went out of the cave and called after Saul, "My lord the king," And when Saul looked behind him, David bowed with his face to the earth and paid homage. And David said to Saul, "Why do you listen to the words of men who say, 'Behold, David seeks your harm'? Behold, this day your eyes have seen how the Lord gave you today into my hand in the cave, and some told me to kill you, but I spared you. I said, 'I will not put out my hand against my Lord, for he is the Lord's anointed.' See, my father, see the corner of your robe in my hand. For by the fact that I cut off the corner of your robe and did not kill you, you may know and see that there is no wrong or treason in my hands. I have not sinned against you, though you hunt my life to take it. May the Lord judge between me and you. May the Lord avenge me against you, but my hand shall not be against you. As the proverb of the ancients says, 'Out of the wicked comes wickedness,' but my hand shall not be against you. After whom has the king of Israel come out? After whom do you pursue? After a dead dog? After a flea? May the Lord therefore be judge and give sentence between me and you, and see to it, and plead my cause, and deliver me from your hand." As soon as David had finished speaking these words to Saul, Saul said, "Is this your voice, my son David?" And Saul lifted up his voice and wept. He said to David, "You are more righteous than I, for you have repaid me good, whereas I have repaid you evil. And you have declared this day how you have dealt well with me, in that you did not kill me when the Lord put me into your hands. For if a man finds his enemy, will he let him go away safe? So may the Lord reward you with good for what you have done to me this day. And now behold, I know that you shall surely be king, and that the kingdom of Israel shall be established in your hand. Swear to me therefore by the Lord that you will not cut off my offspring after me, and that you will not destroy my name out of my father's house." And David swore this to Saul. Then Saul went home, but David and his men went up to the stronghold. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Glorify the Lord, all you works of the Lord. Praise him and highly exalt him forever. In the firmament of his power, glorify the Lord. Praise him and highly exalt him forever. Glorify the Lord, you angels and all powers of the Lord, O heavens and all waters above the heavens, sun and moon and stars of the sky. Glorify the Lord, praise him and highly exalt him forever. Glorify the Lord, every shower of rain and fall of dew, all winds and fire and heat, winter and summer. Glorify the Lord, praise him and highly exalt him forever. Glorify the Lord, O chill and cold, drops of dew and flakes of snow, frost and cold, ice and sleet. Glorify the Lord, praise him and highly exalt him forever. Glorify the Lord, O nights and days, O shining light and enfolding dark, storm clouds and thunderbolts. Glorify the Lord, praise him and highly exalt him forever. Let the earth glorify the Lord, praise him and highly exalt him forever. Glorify the Lord, O mountains and hills, all that grows upon the earth. Praise him and highly exalt him forever. Glorify the Lord, O springs of water, seas and streams, O whales and all that move in the waters, all birds of the air. Glorify the Lord, praise him and highly exalt him forever. Glorify the Lord, O beasts of the wild, and all you flocks and herds, O men and women everywhere. Glorify the Lord, praise him and highly exalt him forever. Let the people of God glorify the Lord, praise him and highly exalt him forever. Glorify the Lord, O priests and servants of the Lord. Praise him and highly exalt him forever. Glorify the Lord, O spirits and souls of the righteous. Praise him and highly exalt him forever. You that are holy and humble of heart, glorify the Lord. Praise him and highly exalt him forever. Let us glorify the Lord, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Praise him and highly exalt him forever. In the firmament of his power, glorify the Lord. Praise him and highly exalt him forever. A reading from St. Paul's Epistle to the Romans, beginning with the 5th chapter, the 1st verse. Therefore, since we have been justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ. Through him we have also obtained access by faith into his grace in which we stand, and we rejoice in hope of the glory of God. Not only that, but we rejoice in our sufferings, knowing that suffering produces endurance, and endurance produces character, and character produces hope, and hope does not put us to shame, because God's love has been poured into our hearts through the Holy Spirit who has been given to us. For while we were still weak, at the right time, Christ died for the ungodly. For one will scarcely die for a righteous person, though perhaps for a good person one would dare even to die. But God shows his love for us in that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Since, therefore, we have now been justified by his blood, how much more shall we be saved by him from the wrath of God? For if while we were enemies, we were reconciled to God by the death of his Son, much more now that we are reconciled, shall we be saved by his life. More than that, we also rejoice in God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have now received reconciliation. Therefore, just as sin came into the world through one man, and death through sin, and so death spread to all men because all sinned. For sin indeed was in the world before the law was given, but sin is not counted where there is no law. Yet death reigned from Adam to Moses, even over those whose sinning was not like the transgression of Adam, who was a type of the one who was to come. But the free gift is not like the trespass. For if many died through one man's trespass, much more have the grace of God and the free gift by the grace of that one man, Jesus Christ, abounded for many. And the free gift is not like the result of that one man's sin. For the judgment following one trespass brought condemnation, but the free gift following many trespasses brought justification. For if, because of one man's trespass, death reigned through that one man, much more will those who receive the abundance of grace and the free gift of righteousness reign in life through the one man, Jesus Christ. Therefore, as one trespass led to condemnation for all men, so one act of righteousness leads to justification and life for all men. For as by the one man's disobedience the many were made sinners, so by the one man's obedience the many will be made righteous. Now the law came in to increase the trespass, but where sin increased, grace abounded all the more. So that, as sin reigned in death, grace also might reign through righteousness leading to eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Lord, now let your servant depart in peace according to your word, for my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared before the face of all people, to be a light to lighten the Gentiles, and to be the glory of your people Israel. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Let us pray. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. O Lord, show your mercy upon us and grant us your salvation. O Lord, guide those who govern us and lead us in the way of justice and truth. Clothe your ministers with righteousness and let your people sing with joy. O Lord, save your people and bless your inheritance. Give peace in our time, O Lord, and defend us by your mighty power. Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten, nor the hope of the poor be taken away. Create in us clean hearts, O God, and take not your Holy Spirit from us. Almighty and merciful God, it is only by your grace that your faithful people offer you true and laudable service. Grant that we may run without stumbling to obtain your heavenly promises. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. O God, the life of all who live, the light of the faithful, the strength of those who labor, and the repose of the dead, we thank you for the blessings of the day that is past, and humbly ask for your protection through the coming night. Bring us in safety to the morning hours, through him who died and rose again for us, your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. O God, the Father, creator of heaven and earth, have mercy upon us. O God, the Son, redeemer of the world, have mercy upon us. O God, the Holy Spirit, sanctifier of the faithful, have mercy upon us. O holy, blessed, and glorious Trinity, one God, have mercy upon us. Remember not, Lord Jesus, our offenses, nor the offenses of our forebears, neither reward us according to our sins. Spare us, good Lord, spare your people, whom you have redeemed with your most precious blood, and by your mercy preserve us forever. Spare us, good Lord, from all evil and wickedness, from sin, from the works and assaults of the devil, from your wrath and everlasting condemnation. Good Lord, deliver us from all blindness of heart, from pride, vanity, and hypocrisy, from envy, hatred, and malice, and from all lack of charity. Good Lord, deliver us from all disordered and sinful affections, and from all the deceits of the world, the flesh, and the devil. Good Lord, deliver us from all false doctrine, heresy, and schism, from hardness of heart and contempt of your word and commandments. Good Lord, deliver us from lightning and tempest, from earthquake, fire, and flood, from plague, pestilence, and famine. Good Lord, deliver us from all oppression, conspiracy, and rebellion, from violence, battle, and murder, and from dying suddenly and unprepared. Good Lord, deliver us. By the mystery of your holy incarnation, by your holy nativity and submission to the law, by your baptism, fasting, and temptation, good Lord, deliver us. By your agony and bloody sweat, by your cross and passion, by your precious death and burial, good Lord, deliver us. By your glorious resurrection and ascension, by the sending of the Holy Spirit, by your heavenly intercession, and by your coming again in power and great glory, good Lord, deliver us. In all times of tribulation, in all times of prosperity, in the hour of death, and in the day of judgment, good Lord, deliver us. We sinners beseech you to hear us, O Lord God, that it may please you to rule and govern your holy church universal in the right way. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to illumine all bishops, priests, and deacons with true knowledge and understanding of your word, and that, both by their preaching and living, they may show it accordingly. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to send forth laborers into your harvest, to prosper their work by your Holy Spirit, to make your saving health known unto all nations, and to hasten the coming of your kingdom. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to give all your people increase of grace, to hear your word with humility, to receive it with pure affection, and to bring forth the fruit of the Spirit. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to bring into the way of truth all who have erred and are deceived. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to give us a heart to love and fear you, and diligently to keep your commandments. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to bless and keep all your people. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, that it may please you to rule the hearts of your servants, our national leaders, and all others in authority, that they may do justice and show mercy and walk humbly before you. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to bless and guide all judges, giving them grace to execute justice and to maintain truth. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to bless and keep our armed forces by sea and land and air, and to shield them in all dangers and adversities. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to bless and protect all who serve their communities by their labor and learning. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to give and preserve for us and for others the bountiful fruits of the earth, so that at the harvest we may all enjoy them. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to make wars to cease in all the world, and to give to all nations unity, peace, and concord. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, that it may please you to show mercy on all prisoners and captives, refugees, the homeless and the hungry, and all those who are desolate and oppressed. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to preserve all who are in danger by reason of their work or travel. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to strengthen the bonds of those in holy matrimony, to uphold the widowed and abandoned, and to comfort all whose homes are torn by strife. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to protect the unborn and their parents, and to preserve all women in childbirth. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to care for those who have lost children or face infertility, and to provide for young children and orphans. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to visit the lonely and those who grieve, to strengthen all who suffer in mind, body, or spirit, and to comfort with your presence those who are failing and infirm. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to support, help, and deliver all who are in danger, necessity, and tribulation. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to have mercy upon all people. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, that it may please you to give us true repentance, to forgive us all our sins, our sin, negligence, and ignorance, and to endue us with the grace of your Holy Spirit to amend our lives according to your holy word. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to forgive our enemies, persecutors, and slanderers, and to turn their hearts. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to strengthen those who stand, to encourage the faint-hearted, to raise up those who fall, and finally to beat down Satan under our feet. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to grant to all the faithful departed eternal life and peace. we beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to grant that in the fellowship of the Blessed Virgin Mary and all the saints, we may attain to your heavenly kingdom. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord. Son of God, we beseech you to hear us. Son of God, we beseech you to hear us. O Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant us your peace. O Christ, hear us. O Christ, hear us. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. O Lord, arise and help us, and deliver us for your name's sake. O God, we have heard with our ears, and our forebears have declared to us the noble works that you did in their days and in the time before them. O Lord, arise and help us and deliver us for your name's sake. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O Lord, arise and help us and deliver us for your name's sake. From our enemies defend us, O Christ. Graciously behold our afflictions. With pity behold the sorrows of our hearts. Mercifully forgive the sins of your people. With favor hear our prayers. O Son of David, have mercy upon us. Be pleased to hear us, O Christ. Graciously hear us, O Christ. Graciously hear us, O Lord Christ. Let us pray. Look mercifully, O Father, on our infirmities, and for the glory of your name, rescue us from all those evils we now endure, and grant that in all our troubles we may put our whole trust and confidence in your mercy, serving you in holiness and purity of life, to your honor and glory, through our only mediator and advocate, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Almighty God, who in your wrath sent a plague upon your own people in the wilderness for their obstinate rebellion against Moses and Aaron, and also in the time of King David, sent a plague of pestilence which killed 70,000, but remembering your mercy spared the rest. Have pity upon us miserable sinners, who now are visited with great sickness and mortality. And in the same way that you then accepted an atonement, and commanded the destroying angel to cease from punishing, so it may now please you to withdraw from us this plague and grievous sickness, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord, our Heavenly Father, whose blessed Son came not to be served but to serve, we ask you to bless all who, according to his steps, give themselves to the service of others, especially those who are laboring in this time of plague. Endue them with wisdom, patience, and courage, that they may strengthen the weak and raise up those who fall, and being inspired by your love, may worthily minister to the suffering, the friendless, and the needy. For the sake of him who laid down his life for us, your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all for your immeasurable love and the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ. For the means of grace and for the hope of glory, and we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications to you, and you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will grant their requests. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen.